The future appears rosy, with Alan Moody talking of the growth in China and the effect of this on global investment. His advice on what areas to invest in is heeded. But despite years of experience and an intimate understanding of the markets, are we really on uncharted territory?
Mark Twain said that history doesn't repeat itself, but it rhymes. So we do spend a lot of time looking at the history of markets, finding periods which have similarities to what we see today. So we do think that you can draw inspiration and instruction from what's happened in the past.
This, of course, with an eye to the future. And conspicuous by its absence was any mention of fintech and blockchains, an area in which Gibraltar is hoping to lead on and is now investing in regulation.
Blockchain, we think, is an enormously promising technology. And as a bank, we're very active in developing our digital footprint and our use of technology from fintechs and so on and so forth. So, but blockchain is going to be key to efficiencies for the global financial system and indeed for other areas that can use that technology going forward.
You separated the technology from the actual cryptocurrency. Why is this? You actually described the cryptocurrency as speculation and not investment. Do you think it doesn't have longevity?
Cryptocurrencies, I think, do have longevity, but I would argue they do not have an intrinsic value. They're worth what an investor is willing to pay. So in that respect, they would qualify more as a speculation, perhaps very profitable, rather than an investment.
But let's put cryptocurrencies to one side. What about the pound versus the euro? What's happening with the traditional currencies?
The pound today is undervalued. We think it remains so, given all of the uncertainties around the negotiation for the exit from the European Union. Against the euro, we would expect that the currency would remain weak on a 6- and 12-month horizon.
And I know that most of your talk was aimed at the big fish, but for individual investors, what sort of areas do you think they should be looking at?
The environment we see in the global economy is supportive for equity markets, for listed shares in companies, which should continue to outperform fixed income investments in portfolios.
For those of us looking at the world from outside the financial sphere, it looks like it's in turmoil. To the unrest, add debt and longer life expectancy. And you question if current models are sustainable. Alan Moody remains optimistic.
And experience tells me that the worst is by no means guaranteed. Human nature and human endeavor do outperform expectations, and I believe strongly that the world will survive all of the problems that you mentioned, and that human society will continue to prosper. So I would caution against being too worried about noise in the markets and encourage investors and individuals to look at the bigger picture.
Kleinwort Hambros believes it's important to show commitment to Gibraltar. It feels these seminars with experts of this caliber reinforces this.